Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show how to create a simple timer with the help of Python. For that we need two libraries. The first one is time library in order to give a delay in your program, and the second thing is play sound library. The reason why I am using play sound library here is after the completion of that time it will generate some sound effects and some kind of audio files. Okay, that's why I am using play sound library here. You need to install these two library with the help of command prompt. Go to command prompt, use this command, install play sound. It says like requirement already satisfied, which means I already installed that, and I want to install one more library for the time. And it is also saying like requirement already satisfied. Okay, then coming to the program, first I am getting input from the user. Example, here I am typing input as 10, means the integer value will be stored in this variable. Okay, then I am using a for loop for iterating multiple times. Here I am using a range function. Okay, so basically what the range function will do means it will iterate the particular loop, the value you mentioned inside the range function. Example, I am giving 10 here means it will iterate the loop 10 times. Okay, example, if I am giving 10 here means first the I value will be 0, then the next iteration it will be 1, and the next iteration it will be 2, like that. It will iterate up to I is equal to 9. It will not consider I is equal to 10. That is the working of the range function basically. Okay, then coming to the logic, we need to design a logic like every second the time will be decreased, right? Example, if I am giving input as 10 seconds means at next second it will be decremented to 9, at next second it will be decremented to 8, like that we need to design, right? For that I am using second minus I. So now I am explaining this logic. Okay, first if you are giving input as 10 means here second will be replaced by 10. Okay, basically first the I value will be 0, here second value will be 10, 10 minus 0 will be 10, so the output will be print like 10 seconds left. Then the next iteration after 1 second, here I mentioned the delay, after 1 second the I will be changed to 1. Okay, here I is equal to 1 and the second will be always 10, it won't change, it is a static value. So 10 minus 1 will be 9 seconds left, like that it will print up to I is equal to 9. Okay, when I is equal to 9, here I is replaced by 9 and here seconds is equal to 10, 10 minus 9 is equal to 1, it will display 1 second left. Okay, after that there is no more iteration in the loop because we mentioned 10 here, so it will iterate up to I is equal to 9 only. Okay, after that it will be completely terminated and it got over. Then it will print boom, time's up, and it will play one audio file with the help of play sound library I used here. Inside that you need to specify the file name and the format of the file. You can see the file name here, it's boom, and its file format is mp3, right? And I store that audio file in my current program location. Okay, now I'm going to run this program. You can see first it will ask input how many seconds you want. I am typing 10 seconds left, like that it will print up to 1 second left. It will not print 0 seconds left because I explained the logic there. And you can see after the completion of the loop it will print time, boom, time's up, and it played one audio file. Okay, that's all about a basic simple timer. If you like this video, kindly subscribe my channel. Keep watching.